in order to make sure that we are doing.
Oke, jumpa lagi. Selamat belajar engineer. Pada kesempatan kali ini kita akan memandu sedikit ya pada acara Australian Protection Symposium. Mungkin saya akan mentranslatekan sedikit beberapa hal tentang yang akan kita bahas di Australian Protection Symposium. Pada kesempatan kali ini yang berbicara adalah Alex Apostolov. Beliau salah satu expertise ya, cukup sangat terkenal di dunia tentang EADs atau pemanfaatan 61850. Pada kesempatan kali ini dia akan membahas tentang pemanfaatan digital substation. Salah satunya adalah 61850. Nah, di situ kita lihat bahwa terdapat centralized substation protection ya, sudah jadi dia sudah mencentralkan substation ya.
Is we are trying to use the IEC 61850 based technology to revisit this concept.
Nah, dia menggunakan 61850 yes yang sangat digunakan di ED untuk meredesain lagi untuk digital substationnya ya.
So we have the process interface units that can be at different kinds, and I will talk a little bit about this later, that provide the interface with the process, so they perform the functionality of several different devices depending on the architecture to bring all the process signals to the communication network through the process bus. And when we talk about process bus, in many cases people think about sampled values, but it is not only sampled values, it is also boost messages.
Jadi ketika di proses bus itu tidak hanya sampel value, value adalah nilai dari besaran-besaran arus, tegangan dan sebagainya, tapi juga berbicara tentang bus, message dan segala yang di dalam 61850. Di mana proses bus bisa berupa menjadi interlocking dan juga controlling ya. Tidak hanya simple value yang memindahkan besaran arus dan tegangan.
Switch gear and monitor the behavior of the power system equipment. Now, this is something that already is available in thousands of substations and has proven very successful, and this is why the use of digital substations is picking up speed, and Australia is one of the countries that is leading in this direction by some very
Jadi dia menjelaskan bahwa di Australia sudah terdapat banyak kesuksesan dalam penggunaan digital substation.
Actually people have started talking about can we do centralized substations based on the 61850.
Jadi setelah digital substation, dia orang-orang engineer berpikir bisakah semua disentralize atau dijadikan satu ya pada satu proteksi.
The non-conventional instrument transformer.
Nah, ini contoh dari protection panel yang cukup banyak ya.
Significant benefits.
Cukup banyak pengurangan karena di situ tidak menggunakan copper atau maga ya.
It can be significantly reduced by using optical sensors.
Dengan menggunakan FO dia mengurangi beberapa kekurangan.
And this is due to several facts. First of all, you saw on the previous slide an optical CT that can be directly installed on the bus bar.
Pada digital substation juga sudah menggunakan optical CT ya, sudah tidak menggunakan CT konvensional atau VT container, sudah pakai NCT ya.
First of all, improve the safety because the optical sensor does not explode like the conventional.
Dengan adanya NCT atau optical CT itu dapat mengurangi resiko meledak untuk pada CT ya.
Analog interface from the instrument transformer to the protection and control equipment, we eliminate the possibility for CT saturation.
dan juga dengan NCT juga dapat menghilangkan kejenuhan, kejenuhan dari CT, dan juga tidak akan ada kemungkinan untuk CT open. CT open ini sangat berbahaya, apabila terjadi dapat merusak sekunder CT dan meledakkan CT tersebut.
In a substation in France a couple of years ago, during the Segre session 2 years ago, and you can see that actually there is no wiring on the back of this relay panel. The only hard wires are the ones for the power supply. Everything else is two sets of fibers that are connecting to the process bus and the station bus in order to implement the functionality. I'm still not sure how, okay. So what you see on this slide is actually a circuit breaker that is called disconnecting circuit breaker that includes not only the breaker but also the disconnecting switches within the same.
Ini dia salah satu teknologi antara penggabungan antara disconnecting switch dan juga circuit breaker.
A very significant saving in the space that is taken in the
tujuan utamanya tetap sama, yaitu pengurangan dari lahan ya, pengurangan lahan dari sebuah gardu induk.
Now when we start thinking about why should we go from a conventional digital substation that I was just describing into a centralized one, and the answer is because we are getting a set of additional benefits that you don't have with the distributed application. So let's look at what these benefits are.
Mr. Alex akan menjelaskan keuntungan dari centralized tadi ya, kan dia menyarankan untuk centralized protection system.
I created this slide 17 years ago when I was still working for Alstom, and we were working in developing the 61850 based devices and communication interfaces and objects.
Mr. Alex sudah membuat slide ini dibangun dari 17 yang tahun yang lalu. Dia berpikirkan bahwa bisa memanfaatkan segala sesuatunya dan di centralize dalam satu.
Actually all this protection, automation and control functionality in individual IDs, because when we implement it in the individual IDs, think about the huge amount of devices that you can have in a large substation. Think about all the interfaces that you have to engineer and monitor, even that you're replacing the hardwire signal exchange with communication boost messages or sampled values. You still have to connect all these devices to the communications network. You have a large amount of data messages floating on the network, and in some cases people were having concerns that this may lead to some bottlenecks depending on the communications architecture. If we bring all of this to a powerful computer or server, we can actually implement a different way of designing the protection, automation and control system. And actually I have been talking about this idea for quite some time, and about 10 years ago it started picking up and people started.
Jadi kalau lihat dari sini, ini adalah CT dan segala peralatan ya, dia dikumpulkan langsung pada satu unit ya, jadi centralized ini. Satu unit IDs, hanya satu ya. Ini semuanya menggunakan digital, pada digital substation ya. NCT menggunakan apa namanya, dia punya fiber optik, dia langsung menuju ke IDs.
Last year, and now we started actually a new working group that is developing a guide for the implementation of centralized protection automation.
Sudah mulai, sudah lama dikembangkan untuk working group atau tim bersama yang mengembangkan centralized system.
In a meeting, a virtual meeting of this working group, going through the outline of this document. So this is something that will be probably available to the industry sometime next year and can help you into making a decision of how to go there. So when you look on this slide, you can see that there is a significant difference with the digital substation I was describing earlier. We have what we call the process interface devices, and these process interface devices can be quite different. There is a wide range of possibilities that I'm going to mention briefly in the coming slides. So here you see a simplified architecture of these CSPACs. This is an acronym for Centralized Substation Protection Automation and Control System. You see the process interface units connected to the instrument.
Centralized Protection Automation Control System.
Switches in the substation yard. Then they're connected to the process bus, and then the process bus is connected
to ini yang arsitekturnya ya, arsitekturnya dari peralatan dia masuk ke Ethernet Network, process bus langsung menuju ke sini, Central Substation Protection Automation and Control System, cuman satu ini aja langsung ditarik ke HMI-nya substation dan juga SCADA.
And this is just logical, but in the reality of a physical implementation, probably we are going to have a certain number of multiple interfaces, because especially if you are implementing a centralized substation protection automation control system that is using the protection required sampling rate of maybe 80 or 96 samples per cycle, we still need, for disturbance recording and power quality applications, a sampling rate of what we have today as 256 samples per cycle in LE. And when we think about redundant streams of data, we are going to have maybe not possible to have 1 gigabit Ethernet.
Jadi walaupun dia menggunakan centralized, tetap bisa ditambahkan beberapa. Dipikirkan mengenai tambahan independent DFR dan power quality apabila dibutuhkan ya, karena kan beda fungsinya. Kalau disturbance fault recorder atau perekod gangguan itu dia mempunyai sample rate atau recordnya akan lebih detail.
Also interfacing with the substation HMI and the SCADA interface and the interface to system integrity protection scheme for whatever else wide area applications that we might be using. Now, when we think about this architecture, something else that we need to think about is the fact that we know how to engineer a distributed 61850 based digital substation. We use the system configuration language to describe the message exchange between the different components of the system.
Aku bisa
so, nggak tahu aku ya di mana posisinya. Nggak ada stick-nya kalau nggak salah di sini.
Nggak ada.
Di sini loh ya.
Can be based on an SCD file or SSD file that is used for a standard substation digital implementation.
Bawa aja.
And in this case, as part of the engineering process, we need to engineer actually the signal flow between the different systems represented by virtual IPs. So this brings me to the issue about the components of this system. What I'm showing here is a process interface unit. This is not a term that is commonly used, but now is starting to become implemented in different standard or secret documents. So as you can see, it contains the merging unit, which we are familiar with, that gives us the current and voltage digitization from the instrument transformers. Then on top of it, we have the SIU, which stands for switchgear interface unit, that gives us the interface with the breakers and switches. And then finally on the bottom, we have the MEI
Jadi sebelumnya itu sudah ada merging unit untuk yang dari CT, PT itu masuk ke merging unit. Dari sini masuk ke merging unit, baru masuk ke EAD. Dan juga ada SEU, itu untuk yang dari kontrol-kontrol ya, kontrol otak XPCR itu dari CB dan XW1 ini dari discontinuing switch. Semuanya dijadikan satu dalam satu unit, yaitu namanya process interface unit.
Non-electrical signals that are required for the different protection automation control applications, and we need to be able to interface with these parts of the process using the non-electrical interface units. So when we integrate all these different virtual modules into a single physical device, this is what I would call a process interface unit. Now the process interface unit is belonging to a different bay in the substation environment. And this is something that becomes also very important. When we start engineering a substation protection automation and control system, it is important to do this in an object-oriented, standardized way. So what I'm showing in these red rectangles is some examples of typical bays in a substation. We have a high voltage transmission line bay, we have a transformer bay, we have a distribution feeder bay, and they all implement a standardized protection automation and control scheme. Each one of these schemes actually contains a virtual ID, and what you see here is a simplified object model of the hierarchical structure of such a virtual ID that contains several virtual logical devices, and these logical devices represent the protection functionality, they represent the recording, the measurements, etc., etc. So all of this has to be built as an hierarchical model using nested logical devices as defined in edition 2 of the standard.
Ini dia ID-nya sudah pakai virtual ya, virtual IDs. Karena di sentral tadi dia harus punya beberapa spesifikasi, yaitu antara lain itu adalah ini logic protection ya, logic protection ya.
Centralized protection automation and control system remains operational, and this is how we can using
mulai dari control, measure sama recording
which components of the system are being tested and which of them are operating performing their normal functionality as required by the substation application. Now, I mentioned as the part of the engineering that we need to define the signal flow. So this is an example of how this is done. So something else that has happened in addition to the standard is we have introduced in every logical node the new data object, which is called input reference. So the input reference actually corresponds to the xref in the SCL, and it allows you to tell the system where the message is coming from. So in the logical nodes there are two actually data objects. One of them is the inref that tells you where the signals are coming from that are used for the normal operation of the logical node functionality. And we also have a second one which is called blockref that tells you which signal we can use to block the operation of the function for some critical protection functions. And this is how in the SCL we can define actually by mapping the inref and the blockref to the xref, we can define the signal flow in order to engineer such a centralized protection and control system. Now, obviously,
ini salah satu topik yang cukup menarik ya, yaitu gimana cara mengkomunisioning atau ujinya dulu kan, karena semuanya sudah sudah digital ya, harus ada gimana caranya untuk paling cocok metode untuk pengujiannya.
This is why, as you can see on this slide, we are using primary injection as part of the commissioning to apply some current and voltage signals to the primary of
dia menggunakan primary test ya. Jadi misalnya kita nginjek arus, dia arusnya kita arus tinggi ya. Ini current buster ya. Dia nembak langsung ke NCT yang di luar, CT optical CT. Jadi NCT dia akan ngirim ke merging unit lewat 61850. Nah, ini sample value-nya dari nilai yang dideteksi oleh NCT akan langsung menuju ke tadi centrales tadi.
Thing that we need to think about is if we are isolating a certain logical node for testing as part the input reference, we have another specific attribute that is called test reference. This allows us to, instead of using the simulation that is typically used for testing in a live
situation, atau juga bisa menggunakan tes lewat ini ya, tes signal test ya, menggunakan GGIO mungkin dari ada alat uji baru juga yang bisa dapat mengirim sample value.
That is coming from a test.
Dan juga signal sesuai dengan yang kita ingin coba.
So this is a very powerful tool that becomes absolutely critical to the centralized implementations. Now, as part of also this testing, it's also very critical to use a white box testing method that allows you to see actually which components of the system are operational as part of the test instead of the traditional black box testing that allows you to see only what is the input and output signals from the black box. But for a centralized substation that has so many inputs and outputs, this is something that is very difficult to implement and understand if something doesn't work, what is the problem with it. Now, I just want to
nah, ini salah satu contoh ya untuk yang centralized protection ini. Ini dia menggunakan salah satu merek ABB ya. Ada banyak sebenarnya, tapi ini mungkin yang sudah digunakan, yang sudah diimplementasikan ya, itu sudah ada di Russian.
And you can see the servers in the panels. And actually they have done some analysis and you can see here the dramatic changes in the amount of space that actually it takes to implement such a substation. So I think I'm running out of time and I just
ini dia menjelaskan bahwa dapat mengurangi dimensinya ya, dimensi dalam suatu sebuah substation.
It was published in December of 2019. So I really recommend that you get this copy of the magazine and go through all the articles that are there, which brings me to the benefits of the CSPAC.
Ini salah satu keuntungan,
meningkatkan
keandalan,
improve cyber security because of the reduced number of targets.
Meningkatkan cyber security karena mengurangi targetnya tadi ya.
The hybrid architecture with a limited number of local protection functions and at the same time supports of all voltage or substation level functions that are executed at the substation server. So this is all I can say in the time that I had available and I will be happy to answer any of your questions at the end.
Okay, mungkin itu aja. Thank untuk centralized ya, cukup menarik. Karena di Indonesia belum ada untuk yang centralized ini, spinal protection ini.
Thank you so much, Alex.
Terima kasih, nanti jumpa lagi di materi berikutnya.